The five stages of the narcissist's social media mind games. Social media is a fantastic resource for a narcissist to play more mind games with others. Some will do, some only do one or two, and some will not be interested in social media at all. It all depends on that particular narcissist. They can and most will use social media through each stage of the relationship, the idealization, the devaluation, the discard and the hoover, or the re-idealization, as an amazing lady commented on the channel, and then the smear campaigns. So just how exactly do narcissistic people use social media to play more mind games with us, to leave us hurt, angry and confused? And what do we need to look out for? Number one, in the idealization stage of the relationship, a narcissist will happily use any form of social media to find people, from dating sites to Facebook, Instagram and Pinterest and all the others. If you did or didn't meet them through social media, most will use it as part of their idealization stage, by gathering as much information about you as they possibly can, so they can easily share your likes and your dislikes, your hobbies, your points of view. When you first start dating them, the idealization stage is when most will raise us up so high, making us feel so special and treating us better than anyone ever has. So how do they use social media to idolize us? Hello everybody and welcome to the channel. I'm Elizabeth Shaw and this channel is all about the narcissistic personality disorder to give you more understanding of what you've been through or those you might be dealing with in your life, how to handle them, things to look out for, and most importantly, how to recover from narcissistic abuse. Thank you very much to all the returning subscribers. I hope you're still finding these videos valuable and informative. If you are new to the channel, please do subscribe and please hit the bell if you want notifications of when a new video is on. So, how do they use social media to idolize us? When you first start dating, they might be regularly posting pictures and updates of you both, wanting to change their relationship status quickly to in a relationship with you. They might get you so that you're waking up and seeing something amazing on your Facebook wall from them, or they've written something brilliant about you, or they've retweeted something of yours. You could be going about your day to day and see a notification of a picture they've put up of the two of you, or another fantastic comment they've left for you. You most likely might start doing this in return, sharing your happiness with your loved ones. You might then start checking your social media to see what lovely comments they've left for you today, as it gives you that boost of inner happiness from the external comments and likes. Healthy couples can also do this just out of love and affection and creating happy memories. Narcissists do this for more sinister reasons. I shall add a video on the signs of a narcissistic person in the description. They use social media to triangulate people. When you first meet them, and they may want you to be the one to send them the friend request, or they might send it to you. They might be playing all the mind games with the exes that one day they will play with you. They can also do this as once you are both posting about how lovely your life is together, when it starts to go wrong, which with a narcissist it inevitably does, we can find it harder than to speak up through our own pride and ego. Speak up, you have absolutely nothing to be ashamed of, and it helps others through these times. Those narcissists not active or wanting to keep you hidden from other partners, they have that you don't even know about. You don't even know they've got other partners. They might tell you that they rarely go on, that they only ever use it for messenger. They prefer being with people. Real life matters to them more. This is only to impress you, so you think that they are real and you admire them, and it's to protect themselves from you finding out about their other partners. Two, then comes the next stage when they begin to devalue us. That leaves us full of uncertainty, questioning what has changed, who have they become, changing ourselves time and time again to please them, learning to walk on eggshells around them, to avoid the silent treatment, the projection, the blame shifting, and everything always being our fault. To avoid their anger and their rage, with their constant gaslighting, we cannot see what's truly happening to us. The narcissist gets us to start overanalyzing everything, think about what their intentions are towards us, even questioning our own instincts, thoughts, and feelings. They were once so loving, so kind, so helpful. We want to stop worrying, yet you cannot help yourself. Anxiety creeps up on us more and more. All the amazing things they've said and done, all the beautiful things they used to put all over social media, for now, they have stopped. You don't want to worry, yet something in your gut is telling you that it's just not right. Either you've been with them a long time, so you don't want to bring up any concerns, because you've got fear of their reaction, or you've not been up with them, been with them for very long, so you don't want to bring it up for fear of concerns that you will come across insecure. So it puts more self-doubt onto you. Are you overreacting? Are you reading too much into everything? Please believe me, you're not. So if you see any of these signs, if you're still in a relationship with someone you believe is a narcissist, do not react or question them. Trust your instincts, as they just want you to react. So trust those instincts and walk away. Follow and listen to them. A narcissist will not validate your feelings. They are playing these games to make you feel insecure. Here are a few other mind games they play on social media during the devaluation. Did you see any of these? And please do add in the comments any that I don't mention that you came across. They might start to remove some of their tags on posts you've tagged them into. Not many to begin with. As time goes on, they'll remove more and more. So you start getting anxious and may start checking your profile more to see if any more have been untagged. If you do ask them, they'll either know nothing about it, blame it on your eyesight, say it's some sort of mistake, you're insecure, and stop reading into things. They may block you for an hour, then unblock you, and they may prevent you from looking at their social media for a day or two, and then unblock you. Again, if you ask them about it, they will most likely act surprised or blame you, say it's the website's fault. They will re-add you, leaving you wondering whether it was a mistake or not. They may cause an argument, go into the silent treatment, disappear, and block you. You may notice frequent likes on someone else's profile from them, that's someone else being of the same sex as you. There might not be any comments left at that moment. More than likely, this will be someone you do not know or haven't even met or heard about. If you start to look through that person's profile, you'll discover that recently the narcissist has liked a lot of their photos or status updates, and the narcissist is most likely trying to triangulate you, or they may be lining up their replacement. They may suddenly add one of their old crazy exes as a friend. You find this very strange, but do not want to ask, as you don't want to come across looking insecure or cause rage in them. You see no messages or likes between them, but you are left thinking, who asked who and what is all this about? You wake up in the morning before they go into their social media. You notice they were active a few hours ago, which leaves you with so many questions such as what were they doing at that time in the morning, or who were they talking to? They may have been actually talking to someone, or if they know you're looking at stuff, it's more mind games. They might have just set the alarm to get up, go on, knowing you'll be up before them looking, just to play more mind games with you. Then you might start to notice the narcissist leaving nostalgic comments on someone else's wall. Yet they've never mentioned this person or things that they did with this person to you before. They might start posting things like, feel like I'm going crazy, yet I'm not crazy, or I'm not alone, so why am I feeling so alone? Again, to get attention and sympathy from other people. There was a time when you did something together, they would tag you on social media. Now they never tag you on anything, yet they are still active. It's not a case of life got busy, you settled down as a couple and just rarely go on anymore. They are always on, commenting on other people's posts, but no longer about the two of you. If you post something tagging them, it doesn't appear on their timeline anymore. They've changed their settings, so they have to approve it first. Now, social media does like to update things, so if the person you are with isn't abusive mentally, physically, or emotionally, it could be genuine. Their phone will be on lockdown. Codes so that you cannot get in, settings change so that messages don't show up, and if you see one, it only states notification, or their phone is always with them or placed screen down because they have things to hide. They do these mind games and others as they want you thinking about it, stuck with that thought of wanting to know, but not wanting to overreact. They want you to spend time looking and seeing what's happening, so your thoughts are on them. Then the narcissist might just go completely quiet on Facebook. If the narcissist in your life likes Facebook and other social media, and then you've probably spotted some of these patterns before, they do enjoy the power of Facebook and manipulative games, the power of social media, and the power of playing games with your mind through anything they can, including Facebook. So they might suddenly just go quiet on there. So when you first met them, they once had a Facebook main page which was updated regularly, always sharing stories, tagging you, frequently changing profile pictures, including you two together at the start, and then just themselves, and then just the children, and then suddenly all goes quiet. Their profile picture stays the same, the timeline goes quiet, they no longer update their status on their achievements, their only thing on the posts or on the timeline are from months or years ago. Why did they do this? They might not be doing anything on their profile page. They could still be using Facebook to watch other people and calculate their next move, to spy on you and to spy on others, to gather as much information as they can about those around them, to see what you're doing, if they want to come and hoover, or what they could come in with to suck you back in, or looking for someone new to line up for themselves if they are devaluing you, ready for the discard. They may have gone quiet on the page you know about, yet they may have another profile set up that you know nothing about. They can also do this as they believe you are less likely to block them on the discard, as you think you know they don't use it, so they can still then check in on your profile after the discard, ready for the hoover. Some will block you, some keep it and don't block you, as they know you might also look in on them. Some will randomly block you during the relationship or during silent treatments to keep you questioning and guessing what's happening. They use it to deny accountability, so you question yourself when you ask them if they are cheating. They may say things like, how can I meet anyone? I never go online. Look at my Facebook. They might let you check their messages because, of course, they will have deleted them all. Then they'll shift the blame onto you for doubting them and treating them how you do, saying that you're too sensitive, too hung up on past relationships, too insecure, to provoke a response for you, to get you to apologize for accusing them of the things that they are actually doing, yet hiding from you. Once you're left feeling vulnerable, they can start with the discard. doing this to you through social media with everything else they do is just another tactic to draw you in and then leave you full of that self-doubt. 3, the discard and also the smear campaign. When they feel you are no longer of any use to them or you've started to wake up to their horrific games, if they have discarded you or if you have safely walked away, ended the relationship and left them. Some of the games they will play on social media. When they meet someone new, or they most likely will have already been with that person before discarding you, they will be on social media again, showing off their new relationship to the world to give that new person the social media hook they did with you at the start. To show everyone else what a healthy, loving relationship they are in and to hide their own faults. Some will use social media on the discard to cause you more discomfort, more pain and question within yourself, often posting pictures with their new partner, looking all perfectly loved up, leaving you questioning, what was wrong with me? There's nothing wrong with you. It's not you. They are the ones that are doing these mind games. Leaving you also questioning things like, what is so special about them? We are all special in our own way, yet to a narcissist, there is nothing special about the new, it's just someone they can use, abuse, and triangulate others with. They might post pictures of them visiting places with the new person that they always promised to take you to rub salt in your wounds, photos in your home with your children to leave you feeling hurt and confused that the new is not over. Living the life the narcissist promised you in the idealization stage and never delivered, but to twist the knife in that they are doing it with your family, leaving you out in the cold, leaving you with the questions of why me, what did I do wrong? You did nothing wrong, it is who they are. Posting status updates of how they've never been happier. They are just idolizing the new like they once did you. They have a disorder, that is who they are. They only see in black and white, and they will continue their life cycles and life patterns, only getting worse with age. You and the new are not in competition with each other, as the narcissist likes to get most people thinking. You have both just been fed lie after lie. A narcissist is a con artist. They start off by selling people dreams of happy ever after and delivering a living nightmare to those closest to them. 4, the smear campaign is further manipulation, mental torture that has us kept in that locked cycle of abuse and hideous games that they play. They will be posting all the pictures of the new relationship to prove to themselves and others that they can be in a relationship and they are healthy. They will have flying monkeys and enablers checking out your social media if you block them, so they can find out what you're up to and go all out to destroy you. If you have a business page, they will most often get enablers to leave negative feedbacks and remarks and comments. They will post about just how crazy you are. Now, the healthy person can share quotes and memes to raise awareness and help others. They do it to destroy your good name. And 5, the Hoover. Even if you think you've blocked them on everything, if you haven't altered your settings so only friends can see, they might just set up false profiles to check in on you, see what info they can gather. Some have been known to reach out through YouTube and eBay when you've blocked them on all of the social media. They might set up new accounts and send you friend requests and messages, even as a false person. They might set up new accounts or have other accounts to spy on you to see if they can find a way back into your life. They might send pictures to your inbox of Facebook memories to pull on your memories and your care inside of that idolization stage. And if you let them back in, they will hit that pattern of repeat as they cycle around their life story, exploiting all others to meet their own needs. So what can you do? My best advice is block all social media contacts that you can. Also blocking mutual friends and family. The hardest part isn't actually blocking them, it's feeling guilty when you do. Remember, you are not doing this to hurt anyone or with any wrong motives. You are doing it for your protection, your sanity, and to leave the past behind, break the cycle, and move forward onto a much happier life. Now, I shall add no contact in the description and also how to overcome guilt. You do not want them having any information about you. They will only ever use it against you. And as much as some people might want to see what they're doing now, if you see something, it'll only bring up past hurts and past pain for you. If you've already looked, don't worry, a lot of people do. Now's the time to make the change and block them. It can be challenging to start. Human nature to check in on someone that you once were close to. Trying to get that closure, those answers. There's a big difference between the narcissist checking in on you. They do this to spy, to find ways to suck you back into their games. When you look, you often do it for answers, to try and give yourself that closure, yet you often end up feeling much worse for doing so. Acknowledge that you want to look, then tell yourself that you will not, as you'll often be left feeling worse. Find something, anything to do to keep your own mind busy and avoid checking in on them. Learning about the disorder, who they are, and what has happened to you helps give you the closure you need to move on. You might get your answers and walk away altogether, breaking the cycle, working on you, and living a much happier life. You might learn what you need to learn, break the cycle, create new experiences, yet still look up the disorder now and again, purely because you're fascinated in the psychology behind the human mind. So long as you leave the past behind, both the normal, healthy, and whatever works best for you, you will get to a point where you see their games, understand what they do, and get busy working on yourself, your life, so you are no longer interested in focusing on that in a negative, hurtful way, more just gaining knowledge and awareness. You might be one that joins groups as you have a passion for helping others through, or completely walk away from it. Do what is right for you, as it becomes just memories of the past, and that's where you want to leave it, where it belongs in the past. Yes, those dark cloud moments of painful memories can hit from time to time, often becoming less and less over time. Yet when they do come, depending on how they make us feel, we might question, are we truly over it? Are we really healed? And when these hit, you must remember that's your past. You lived it. That those memories are to remind you of the strength and the knowledge that you have gained, to show you how far you have come and to remind you of a life that you no longer live and you don't want to live again. Remind you of your happiness that you have built up for yourself now, to be grateful for what you have achieved and how you've used your most significant hurt and pain of the past to drive you to make your most significant gains of your future. Remember, forgiveness is for you, so you can walk away, heal, and move on. And if you're at the start, it's okay to feel anger, resentment, pain, normal human emotions with what you have been through. Keep working on you and you will move past it. Keep going, reach out, talk to good people, get the help and support that you need. Talking, it really does help, but talk with the right people. It does get easier. Keep going, you can and you will recover from this. Thank you for listening. Bye.